Ashwini, Assistant Professor, Department of ISE, STBIT. Welcome to ST Lab. Program 10, Binary Search Program.
Program 10, Binary Search. This has to be tested using PAT testing. So let us understand what is binary search first. First, you ask the user to enter the elements in ascending order, and we also ask the enter the key element to be searched. If the key element is found in the list, we print suitable message telling that element found. If the key element is not found, we print message that element is not found. Let us see the logic for binary search. So I have declared some variables. I will ask the user to enter the value of n, read it inside a variable n. Next, I will ask the user to enter the elements in ascending order and read it inside an array A. Next, we ask the user to enter the item to be searched or element to be searched and read it inside key. Next, I will call a function called binary search and pass the array lower, low, high and the key value. So going to the function, you have the array low, high and key. The logic for binary search is, till low is less than high, we compute something called mid. What is mid? Mid is nothing but low plus high by 2. And if x of mid is equal to key, I can tell, okay, element was found. If x of mid is less than key, I would reposition my low to mid plus 1. So I would tell that, okay, element is greater than mid, it should be available on the right side of the array. If not, I would reposition high to mid minus 1. What this means? The key element is found towards left side of the array. So I would repeat this process till low is less than high. So at some point of time, if high comes behind low or low comes behind high, it means the element is not found. In that case, I would return minus 1. So it would come here and I would tabulate that in a variable called success. If success is equal to 0, element found at position would be printed. If not, element is not found. Let us see how we can do PAT testing for this program. For doing PAT testing, first you should be able to represent your program into a program graph. A program graph is nothing but the same program, every statement is represented using nodes and edges. Here we have applied the program graph only for the function. You can apply it on the entire program also. So we have applied binary search, that is program graph, only for binary search function. So at the end you would get a program graph something like this. 1, 2, 3. Okay, if x is equal to key, you're telling it's true and you're terminating the program. If that is false, you are checking whether key lies towards left side of the array or right side of the array, and you are repeating that process, repeating this process. So once you have the program graph written like this, next, using McCabe's equation, you can identify how many independent paths exist. That is given by the equation E of G is equal to edges minus nodes plus 2 into P, where E stands for number of edges, these lines, N stands for number of nodes plus 2 into P. P is number of connected regions. So typically this is going to be 1. So totally you have 11 edges for this program graph, 9 nodes plus 2 into 1. So you end up getting 4. What it means, in this program graph, there are 4 independent paths that can be traversed. So we try listing that 4 independent paths. So path 1 is 1, 2, 3, 8, 9. Path 2 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 2. And path 3, path 4 likewise. So once you can identify how many independent paths exist, The next step would be generating test cases that can traverse each of this path. So I would tabulate my test case something like this. I want to generate some test case that can traverse path 1. Path 1 was 1, 2, 3, 8, 9. That is 1, 2, 3, 8, 9. So I would enter elements where the key element is found exactly in between, so that it's going to terminate here. So for that, okay, the elements were 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Element is exactly found in between. So first path got traversed. Next, one more path, again 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Element found towards right side of the array would traverse this path. Again, the key element to be searched is 10. Element, that is key element, found towards left side of the array. This test case would traverse this path. And lastly, element not found. So for this, you can take element not found towards the left side of the array or right side of the array. So totally four paths would be traversed. So we can conclude that binary search is working properly and all the paths are executed at least once. Thank you.